This is Devin Williams with NBA Playmakers. I'm out in Chicago at the 2017 NBA Draft Combine. I'm really excited, but I will tell you that I am a little bit of a skeptic. Now, what my job is today is go around to all these stations and figure out how all this translates. So now you got a player like John Wall, and now you got another player like Isaiah Thomas, both playing at a very high level all year. But John Wall, you would expect him to kill all this. Isaiah Thomas, he went 60th in the draft, and you see what he's doing today. So I want to get a little bit more information to get closer to figuring out the truth behind all this. Let's go check it out.
First thing, we want to make sure you're ready to go. Okay. We're never going to do anything to put in a guy in a position to get hurt here. So we're going to make sure that he's absolutely ready to go for every test we're going to put him through today. We're going to start you on the sideline right here. All we're going to do, we're going to start you out with a knee tuck. Yeah. Take this knee, pull it up your chest. We're going to work all the way to the midline of the court. Drive your foot into the ground, get tall. There you go. I want you driving that leg up, right, lead with your heel all the way to the midline of the court.
All right, cool.
Drive it up, drive it up, drive it up. There you go. Knee up, toe up. Good. Shoulder square to the sideline. There you go. Karaoke down and back. There you go. Good. Get your hips moving. Move, move. There you go. Good. Midline and back.
I'm ready to hoop.
Good stuff, man.
Appreciate you, man.
You got it.
You heard it from the man himself. This is how they get down out here. I'm headed to the next station. I'm already tired. Cliff is going to show us how this lane agility works.
We're going to start in front of the cone. We're going to have the guys who sprint, come around this cone, shuffle, 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 shuffle. Back pedal, back pedal, back pedal, back pedal, back pedal. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Hit. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Decelerate, accelerate, decelerate. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Back pedal, back pedal, back pedal, back pedal, back pedal, back pedal.
What do you say after you see them do this drill? What are you looking for?
So that's a great question, actually. So first thing I'm looking for is how they accelerate.
Right.
How they start to maximum speed, how they decelerate, how they change speed with the shuffle, how they back pedal, stop, load, and explode. It's all about reaction time, because in the NBA as a defender, you're reacting guys driving, you're reacting guys coming up, challenge a shot.
What I want to figure out is some guys who came here, killed this whole drill, and now it translated to the court. They're like killer defensive players, maybe Kawhi. Who'd you
Some good examples that come off are guys like John Wall, Russell Westbrook's a good defender, Patrick Beverley, Avery Bradley's a phenomenal defender.
All right, man, I appreciate your help.
Yeah, man.
I'm going to move on to the next drill. I want you to run me through everything that we're getting ready to do.
What we're going to do is we'll have you start in just a two-point stance. Okay, you can get your toe as close to that line as you can. Okay, we don't want you to cross over that. Okay. All right. Big thing here is we just want to make sure that your hips are pointed forward. We don't want you starting in a staggered stance there. However you want your arms to set, okay? And not much more to explain. We just want you to run as fast as you possibly can. Hard sprint out.
Go, 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 go.
Oh. Oh, you letting up. Not too bad, man. Three too late.
I do have a question, though. So how does all this translate? Being that we're not track runners, you know, we're basketball.
Absolutely. Right? I mean, what the combine does in general with all their tests is it gives us a way to help us compare each athlete. Although we can see, you know, the basketball talent through them playing, this gives us objective measures through their talents from a sports performance standpoint. Right.
So you start here, nice athletic base. On you, it's gonna be turn and run. Your foot is gonna touch this outside line. So turn, run, have to touch this outside line. If you miss, does not count, we will start over. So touch this line, come through, touch the other line with your foot, come through, finish through this middle cone.
We're stopping, we're turning. What move does that simulate in an actual basketball game?
So there are multiple. It's just lateral agility. So when you think basketball, you want to be able to stay in front of your man.
Definitely.
It's one of the biggest things. If I'm able to move quickly laterally, I'm able to stay in front of my guy. Also, first step. So if I have the ball, my first step, if I'm faster, all it takes is a half a second.
What are some of the muscles that help me get off to the next spot quicker?
The main thing with quickness is force distribution. You're always putting force into the floor. Best way to do that, have strong legs, strong glutes. So quads, hammies, glutes. You think like a squat or a deadlift, those help you get out of those positions very quickly.
Is it more important to do eccentric exercise as opposed to pushing off or stopping?
That is a great question. So you can't have a fast car without good brakes.
Exactly.
You need to have an eccentric amount of strength to get in and out of your cuts efficiently.
Okay.
So if you were to come into a cut lacking eccentric strength, what's gonna happen is you get here and you're gonna crumble because you don't have strength to slow yourself down.
Right.
Now, if you're eccentrically strong, you quick breaks.
Perfect.
Quick eccentric.
Okay, so now the last question. Who are some of the record setters?
For this drill, I know Malcolm Brogdon tested very well. Isaiah Thomas also did very well. You got to think like you're shorter, usually shiftier guys.
All right, next up, we have Trent with the Detroit Pistons. We're at the vertical jump station, and I want to see how all this works. Now, I've seen this a lot, all right, with the NBA Combine, grew up watching it. How does all this translate to the game?
Sure, well, vertical jump, obviously, guys like the sky above the rim, dunk it. So we'd like to see actually two different vertical jumps. The first one right here is a standing vertical jump. Not allowed to move. All you do is you keep your feet stationary, down and up, as high as you can.
I'm thinking of teams like the Golden State Warriors. Stephen Curry, I mean, while he may be able to dunk, doesn't necessarily jump as high as somebody like old school Vince Carter. So how can this get you guys closer to drafting a player like that?
Sure, yeah, great question. So what we like to do is to correlate some of the things that we see on the court to the performance in these metrics as well. I wouldn't say we base all of the decisions for draft picks on simply these performance metrics. We like to say, hey, a guy looks like he can jump really high playing the game. What's his vertical jump look like?
Right. All right, so I'm curious, who are some of the guys that impressed you out here?
As you can see, I'm not very tall, so I'm a little partial to the smaller guys that have done well. Nate Robinson in the past, Spud Webb, some of the guys that were a little shorter but could still jump really high.
For the last test, you had to stand just straight still. You had no running start at all. This time, we're going to give you a 15-foot running start anywhere within the semicircle. So it's taped off here in red. You can go off 1 foot, 2 feet. Some guys like to come around and do like a little curl. Some guys will just kind of drop step into it. Doesn't matter what you do, just get as high as you can any way you can.
What does this tell you about a guy, say he gets up and touches the top?
It just tells you about their maximum power. It's explosive power. It's how well you are at translating force with your body weight. You could be a really explosive guy, but you know, if you weigh a lot and you're not able to translate it into an athletic setting, then it doesn't really do much for you. If you think about it, right, a jump is applying force into the ground. Mm-hmm. So if you get yourself stronger, you're going to be able to apply more force into the ground. You're going to be able to shoot yourself up a little higher. Single leg squats, lunges, double leg squats, all that stuff that's going to help, you know, develop your hamstrings, your glutes, your quads, your calves. It's going to help you produce more force through the ground and translate to a bigger jump.
All right, right on, man. Well, this is Brent. Show me how to get my vertical up, and everybody else, for you guys out there, take note of what he said. Thanks for your time.
No problem, man.
I'll catch you next time.
Sounds good.
The teacher has now become the student. Each station that I went to, they gave me up on everything, how everything works. As I was a skeptic before, not so much now. But it'll be interesting seeing how all this plays out. I'm Devin Williams. I'll see you guys next time.